Come on, some smallmouth. Big smallmouth. What do you think, loon? Smallmouth around here? I think there is. Here we go. Oh my God. There's fish all around here. You know, you want to just trigger. Look at a streaking fish everywhere here. Wow. What are they eating? Yet. Smallmouth, I hope. Yep, and good too. Wow. Right where that loon was. Oh, and he's got a couple buddies with him too. Oh my God. Had a couple buddies with him too. It's a little premature. Or you're just so fat you can't really pull hard, huh? Oh, he ain't ready yet. He's spitting out all kinds of junk too. Take your time. Look at him shaking his head around, hey? What a jumper. What a jumper. Oh, nice fish, boy. Look at him. Oh, God. He looked beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful smallmouth. I mean, just gorgeous fish. Just in the top of the mouth, too. Wow. Look where that is, hey? Look at that. Right in the top of the yap. Grab my little pliers. And that's it. That's all you got to do. I'd say he's good for a picture, isn't he? Wow. Beautiful, nice, long, Northern Ontario smallmouth bass. Sitting on the edge of the weeds. Different location. Same presentation, but a pattern. Pattern is different locations on a lake that you have the same presentation, the same characteristics, okay? I'm going to keep it real simple. This isn't, you know, science 101. It's about finding similar areas where you're catching fish that day or even that hour, because it does change. We've got a low ceiling, they're not chasing topwater, spinner bait, crankbait, nothing. Try the drop shot, wasn't working. Stick worm, patience, throw, sink, twitch, boop. That's what happens. Let's get a few more.